So today I'm going to teach you how to go from this short look to a flawless microlink install. So here are just some pictures of hairstyles that I did. I also did my hair, my friend's microlinks. So there they are. You can also put it up in a bun. So the first things first, I love to do some hair care before I install. So my favorite thing to do is to put weave spray on my scalp, and then I'll also use a anti-humidity spray just so that I don't have to straighten my hair so much. So it's called Hella Dry, and I'll show it in the next frame. It's actually a water repellent and an anti-humidity spray. So what I actually like to do with my microlinks, just because I am natural and I don't want to damage too much of my hair, I actually do a sew-in in the back. So I leave some hair out in the perimeter, and I braid down 2/3 of my head in the back, right above where I left some leave out, and then I'll do the top in microlinks. I've done a full head before, and I've just noticed that this is just what works best for me. So here I am, just, you know, making sure that my hair is fully dry, fully brushed out before I press it. And, you know, I use the chase method. That's the best way to go without having to do multiple passes. And I like to make sure that my hair is very, very pressed before I install the microlinks. So here we are with fully pressed hair. You see how short my hair is. It's not very long. And here I am doing the parting. So I don't really do straight parts for the microlinks. I like to do curves. And what this helps with is when you want to put your hair in a up-down do, or if you want to do a top knot. Because if it's straight, you'll be able to see the tracks. But if you do the U part all up to the top, you'll be able to do more versatile styles. So here's the first track laid out from one ear to the other in the U form. So here I am just getting ready to take a part in my head. So you really want to make sure that when you're parting that you don't leave too little space so that you don't see the track, of course, but also not too much space, just because a gap can make the hair lay a little uneven. You don't want that much of your hair out, if that makes sense. You know, when you're attaching it to the track, it's almost like it's covering your hair or almost protecting it a little bit. So, you know, when your hair is a little less exposed, you know, it won't get wet, things of that nature. So you see that I'm doing a curved part, right? Like I said, for the up down and the top knot, trust me on this, it really works wonders to do curves instead, and it also makes it easier to blend the hair this way. It's easier to blend the hair this way, and I just don't have that much trouble with my track showing since I've done curved parts versus straight back. So basically, this is what differentiates this method from all the other methods. So there's no thread, no glue, no nothing. It's simply just the bead. So you're gonna take a small strand of your hair and a tiny strand of extension, and you're going to, you know, hold those together. As you see right now, I'm struggling a little bit because my nails are long, but I'm holding both of them, and I put them through the loop. And the reason why you want to put it through the loop is so that you can get it through that bead with no problem. And then I just pulled it out of the bead just like that, no problem. Now I'm pulling the bead all the way to my scalp, but not too close, and I'm closing it with the wrench. You can use any wrench. Now, there are specific wrenches for microlinks, but I feel like that's more of a money grab. So here we are again. You know, we're just taking a piece of our hair, right? A small piece of our hair and a piece of the extension. And we're gonna hold that together. And then we're going to get our looping tool, right? Here's our looping tool. And we're going to grab the hair and put it through that looping tool. Here we are. So now you're gonna take this bead and you're going to bring it down near the scalp, and you'll be able to pull the hair out into the bead using the looping tool, if that makes sense. So the bead will be on there using the looping tool, and now you can tighten it. So I will show you again. So this is gonna sound tedious, but I want you to really grasp the concept of the Matawi method. So the steps are: take a piece of your hair, take a piece of extension hair, hold it together, put it through the looping tool, bring the bead down, pull the hair into the bead. So once you pull the hair, it will be inside of the little bead, and at that point you can lock it with your wrench. So here we have our extension hair and our hair. We're gonna hold that together. Right, we're gonna hold that together. We're gonna hold that hair together. Damn, how long did I fucking hold this hair for? Sorry, I'm gonna edit that out. And then we're gonna take the looping tool and pull the hair through it. Now we take the bead, pull it down near the scalp, take the looping tool and pull it. And once we pull it, the hair will be attached by the bead. Right? So here's the bead right there, and I'm pulling it up. I'm going to take my wrench right there. You see the bead? I'm gonna take my wrench, pull it closer to my scalp, and then I'm gonna lock it. Boom. Boom. And there you go. A second bead. So I usually do, we'll say, 3 to 4 beads, sometimes 5, but I don't like them to be too bulky. But again, here we are. We're gonna find some of our hair, take a small piece. And please make sure to take your time with this, because you know, the faster you do this, you know, you can make some mistakes and then it could be bumpy, you have beads showing. So, you know, just make sure you take your time and make sure you take small pieces, because if you take big pieces, it will probably get stuck in the bead and you'll probably deal with some damage or a lot of shedding. So make sure that it's small pieces, right? So we have our piece of hair, and now we have to take our extension hair. Hold that together while we grab the beading tool. The looping tool with the beads, I should say. The looping tool that has the beads on it. So now you take the hair and you put it through the looping tool. You're gonna take that bead and bring it down by the scalp. Right? I'm having trouble because of my long nose. And then you're gonna pull that hair through that bead using that looping tool. Right? Now you see the beads. You might not be able to see it. And you take that wrench, you bring it up. See, I moved a little closer so you guys can see. Bring it up, lock, flatten it. Just squeeze and you'll flatten it and it'll lock in place. So there is a full track using the Matawi method. Do you see how flat that is? Okay, no needle, no glue. Okay, boo boo. And then it just combs out so flat, so natural. It, like, who hair this ain't, okay? You cannot tell me this is not my hair. Like, get out of here with that. So I'm just flipping it over just to show you how versatile it is and how well it lays on both sides, right? It looks a little bumpy right now, but when I comb it out, I swear I will make you a believer. I love this method. I do not do my sew-ins any differently. I also don't do the individual micro links just because it takes a lot of time. And I also think that the braidless sewing is like just an extra step for no reason. So I like this. You know, I cut my sewing time in half. It used to take me 2.5 hours. And I think I can say that this takes me an hour and a half, you know. So yeah, you know, it lays so well and it blends in with my hair. This is actually raw Indian hair, so it is a little coarse, and when it is pressed, it's closer to more of a relaxed texture or a pressed texture of like natural black hair. So I also really like this. Keep it all the love I got. Hair back and forth. No relationships involved. Keep it strictly physical. If you're still interested, you know, please make sure you comment on the video if you want to see something more detailed. Have a nice day.